Ooh, this is not a keeper. How fast can I mulligan to six? That fast. Yeah, I can keep this. The hand's not the greatest, but we can play a Blood Moon, and hopefully that does something. A Simian Spirit Guide off the top would be amazing, because I could just turn one this Blood Moon. I guess I have another draw towards it. I'm gonna fire it off. And also collect some information here. Alright, so when I am playing Moto, I like to take snapshots. It's basically writing down their hand, only like it's one click. The internet makes everything better, man. Computers and such. So he's got a remand and a counterflux. That's really good. Just really strong. Oh, he naturally drew a mountain. His hand is no longer really strong. And in fact, doesn't really do anything anymore. Maybe I should have more Blood Moons in the sideboard. Because this feels sweet. I guess I cycle this. Engineered explosives was revealed. Doesn't quite do anything yet, but he can blow up my chrome box here if he wants to, which I'm kind of okay with. Solary just sent me a message, and it was just, "You are literally the worst." I don't think he's pleased of getting Blood Mooned out of the game. If he feels better, I have now produced more Traveler's Amulets than I can actually search for lands, so this last one's gonna be dead. On the plus side, any Mox Opal I draw will be turned on. He's still playing, man. Hey, Mox Opal. Alright, that's a good reason to play this here Traveler's Amulet. I'm not going to play the Mox Opal, because he could have a second Engineered Explosives and play it and pop it for zero. Now when I have four mana in case I draw Belcher here. We've done a Blood Moon, don't mind if I do. Oh, maybe I should play the Mox Opal just in case I had Miracle Reforge the Soul. That would actually be really smart. On the other hand, it's also a storm count for Empty the Warrens, and there's only one Reforge the Soul in here. Yeah, so it just makes sense not to play it. He's gonna draw a mountain, huh? Alright, now I can play redundant Mox Opal, that's fine. And fire this bad boy off. I hope he doesn't burn me out. Okay, he does have another Engineered Explosives over there. I'm just gonna hold the Mox Opal. And wait a turn here. Remand, Counterflux, Engineered Explosives, even Mind Sensor. Blue mana. I bet he's excited. I am just going to wait. He doesn't actually have a threat, but he has Counterflux and Remand mana now, which is really unfortunate. So we're just going to sit here, and he can't really tap out. Man, he's probably got like a basic island in there. That's fine. I mean, I didn't draw a threat to put him away in time, so... The best way... Yeah, we can't even end the game with Empty the Warrens. Because he has Engineer Explosives. I wonder if I can bait the explosives. He thought for a second there about whether he should remand the Lotus Bloom. So because I want him to play an Explosives and pop it for zero, I'm running out this Mox Opal. I don't think it's going to do anything though. Bolt in my face, sure. So at this point, we basically need multiple Belchers or he does. He falls for our trick. So now Empty the Warrens is live again, which we have plenty of mana for. Street Wraith. I'm not actually going to cycle that yet. We're down to 10 here. If he snapcasted back a Bolt, we'd be in, under some real pressure. It's a Goblin Charbelcher, huh? Again, his hand is remand counterflux, so we're gonna see if we can draw. That's a little better. I'm gonna wait one more turn though, because I'll get that storm count off the Lotus Bloom as well as just to pile more mana. Then I think we will have won this very grindy game. Yeah, he just tapped his blue source for us. He has 5 mana up, 2 bolts in the graveyard. I'm just gonna start cycling Metamorphose. Reforge this hole, sure. So something's gonna have to go underneath this Chromox, and I think it's gonna be that Reforge the Soul. We don't have quite enough mana to play an activate Charbelcher, which is why I am cantripping. Such street rates. Alright, I'm gonna probe him. Make sure that I'm not dead if I cycle all these street wraiths. Let's see, there's a wear and tear, there's a counterflux, there's 2 Aven Mind Sensors. I think I'm probably best off just making some Empty the Warrens tokens, to be honest. He should have saved his second engineered explosives. Cause like why would I play those cards out? Like I already knew that the explosives was in his hand, so why would I play out the Mox Opal alongside the Lotus Bloom unless I wanted to bait it? So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 mana. We could cycle to try and hit for Goblin Charbelcher activate. Yeah, that actually makes a lot of sense. I kind of wish I'd waited to imprint that Street Wraith. I forgot that I have actual all of my mountains in play right now. So the Belcher activate is a hard win. Right, how about that? How about that Belcher? These games are going fast. I like that last game. There's a whole lot of sitting there with the Blood Moon in play. Yeah, I think he got a little bit impatient twice that game, once with Engineered Explosives and then once with the Remand. My life's a little bit more hard if he holds up Remand and Counterflux for a potential Goblin Charbelcher. Anyway. Like, there's so many turns have gone by that I've probably hit mana sources by this point.